4 questions out of 20 questions in the verbal reasoning section of GRE. That's 20% of all the questions. Easy pickings, but students often find them confusing. Yes, I am speaking about sentence equivalence. Make sure you're watching this video till the end to understand the tips and strategies that you need to crack these questions. In our previous videos, we looked at tips and strategies to crack different kinds of questions that you see on the GRE. Sentence equivalence is one such question type. It is easy provided you know what to do. Students often confuse this with the text completion or the typical fill in the blank questions where you are given a sentence or sentences with a few phrases or words omitted. For each of these blanks, in your typical one blank text completion, you are given 5 options. In some cases, you might see 2 and 3 blanks as well. Sentence equivalence is very close to the one blank text completion questions where yes, one of the words or phrases is omitted and you need to fill it in. But in your single blank text completions, you are generally given 5 options and you need to choose one of them. Whereas for sentence equivalence, you are given 6 options and you are needed to choose 2 of them. And that is where the confusion starts. How do I select these 2 words, right? If I look at the instruction for the sentence equivalence questions, select 2 words that fit into the sentence to provide you a coherent whole, but also give similar meaning sentences. So your objective is not to choose synonyms from the given 6 options. Your objective is to choose 2 words that will make sure the sentence sounds similar. The strategy that we use in order to crack questions like this is very similar to the one that we have used for our text completion questions. Yes, the 4-step strategy. What is the first step? Step 1, break down the sentence using logical connectors or punctuation marks into smaller chunks. Step 2, identify the logical connectors, how they actually change the tone or continue the tone between the different fragments. At the same time, look at the keywords in each of these components. The keywords are the words that give you the tone of that fragment. Rajesh is a handsome young boy. There, if I look at it, handsome and young are telling me something about Rajesh and can probably be the keywords. So in my step 2, I will look at the keywords in each of these fragments and also understand how the logical connectors are changing the tone from one fragment to the next. Step 3. Identify the relationship between the blank and the keyword on account of the logical connectors, sentence structures, etc. By now, you should have had a fair idea of what can come into the missing blank, depending upon the keywords and the logical connectors. So far, we have not done anything different from what we have done in our text completions. But this is where sentence equivalence changes a little. Now that I know the kind of word that I'm looking for, I will run through my options. Generally, when you look at the GRE, most of the questions, for this among the 6 options, you will find 2 pairs of synonyms. That's the easiest variety. 2 pairs of synonyms, and given that you already know the word that you are looking for, all you need to do is probably select the right set of synonyms. However, in some cases, you might end up with words which are not synonymous in nature, but when you put them into the sentence, they will give you a similar meaning. right? They might not be synonyms right away, but when you put these words into the sentence, they will give you a similar meaning. Another layer of difficulty that you might also sometimes come across is when you have multiple options, which all of them can actually fit into the sentence and give you a logically correct meaning. You know, let us say there are three options and all three of them can fit into the sentence, but you will only be able to select two out of those three because the third word there does not have a matching counterpart to give you a similar meaning to a sentence. Right? So my step one, I have broken down the sentence into smaller fragments and using logical connectors, sentence structures, punctuation marks. We have done this multiple times in our previous videos. Step two, I identify the keywords and I try to figure out how is the tone changing from one fragment to another fragment. Step three, I guess the word that can come into the blank. Step four is where I start looking at the options, the multiple difficulty, the multiple kinds of difficulties that can actually come in, and I try to choose two words which need not always be synonyms to but give me a similar meaning when put into the sentence. Easy. I hope it was easy. But yes, unless we take up a practice question and look at it in a little more detail, it can become difficult. So I suggest you move over to Kondira online website, take a few practice questions and use the strategy, the four-step strategy that I just explained to crack the sentence equivalence questions. However, sentence equivalence is not the only question type that you're going to see. 20% of the questions are going to be sentence equivalence, but there are going to be your single blank text completions, multiple blank text completions, critical reasoning, reading comprehension, and we have videos where we help you understand the tips and strategies to crack these questions. You can look at some of these videos on vocabulary, how to tips to learn vocabulary, tips to score 155 plus in the verbal reasoning section, as well as to attack other question types. But as I have said, strategy only gives you the direction. Practice to make sure this strategy works for you in all the cases. Good luck, and I will see you in the next set of videos. Please do make sure that you like this video as well as subscribe to the Kondira online channels to receive continuous updates on tips and strategies to do well in various exams. Thank you. Have a great day.